In this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily create a professional email signature for your business emails without paying for any generator and without having an email signature that looks weird on mobile or different email programs. If you don't have the best business email account with Google Workspace yet, check out this video here where I'll walk you through exactly how to set that up. Now let's get your beautiful professional email signature. In case you're wondering why you should have a business email signature, well, first of all, it makes it really easy for the other person to have your contact details, but it also is a really good opportunity for you to showcase your brand. Basically, it also works as an introduction if you've never talked to that person before, and as your digital business card. Also, you can add a booking link to your calendar to make it really easy for people to book a meeting with you. Or you can use it as an opportunity for social proof, so add some reviews in there or a link to your Google reviews or something like that, as well as adding your latest promotion for your business or whatever event you have coming up, these sort of things. So if you want to create a professional email signature for free that also works on mobile, then just keep on watching.
Okay, so the easiest way to create a professional email signature, just open a Google Docs document, which you can just find under docs.google.com. You can create a free account if you don't use Google Workspace anyway. Just create a document where you can basically type in add and create your email signature, and then later on we're going to copy it into your email program. So first of all, the ingredients that you want to have in your email signature is obviously, first of all, your name and your position, so that people know who you are. If you obviously have a bigger business, you want to put in the position that the person has. It is really nice to have to include a picture. It just makes it a bit more personal, and people get more of an impression of the person behind the email. You can, as I said, you can add in a booking link for your calendar for people to book a meeting with you. And then obviously your contact details, you can add your working hours, for example, your social media icons and links, and anything else that you might want to add, like client testimonials, social proof, your next event, whatever makes sense in your business. That ideally you want to use your brand colors and fonts. However, as it is email, you kind of need to stick to a font and color that is actually available on all computers, because not all fonts are. So I definitely recommend to stick to something that is available everywhere. Or if you are using Gmail, you'll see that you can actually only pick colors and fonts that are available throughout Gmail. So you should be pretty safe with those, and just make them as similar as you can to your actual brand colors. So now, basically, I've just written this down. I like to make the name bold and in a different color. Just space it out nicely so that it's easy to read and easy to find the information. For the images, basically, I just created a template in Canva. So what you can do here is, this is just a frame. So you can just go to Elements. Search for a frame, and you just use the circle, drag it as big as the workspace here is. I think this is actually 500 pixels by 500. However, you can export it in a smaller size so that it actually fits into your email signature. It's not too big, but just make sure that you don't have too much spacing around it. And what you do is just upload your image and, yeah, just drag whichever image of yourself that you have as your email signature image, drag it in here, and it's going to make this nice round cutout. However, you don't need to. You can also have a square image or whatever you prefer. And then you can just export it through here and basically insert it into your email signature by just pressing insert image, upload from computer, find it in your download folder, put it in here, and then you can also adjust the size if you need to. This one, at this stage, it's only there's no link behind it. It's just kind of a placeholder where I'm going to put the booking link later on. And then these little icons here, Again, I got them from Canva. You can just get them from the elements in here. Just search for YouTube icon. And you get a range of different options of what you prefer here. Same goes for all the other social channels. Just make sure they're all kind of the same looking ones, whether you use the round or the square ones. And then you can change the color up here and make them all the same color. And then again, just export them, download here, all pages, choose the right size, depending on how they fit into your signature or how big you want to have them, and download them all. And then the same way, add them to your email signature in here. And then you can just copy the whole thing. You just go into your Gmail inbox, into the settings up here, and scroll down to where you've got email signature, and you just create a new signature. Just gonna call that test, and then you essentially just drop it in here. So paste it in there, make sure everything has come through properly, and then you wanna just add the link. So mark this one, click on the link, and just drop in your calendar booking link URL. Same goes for your social icons, so just click them, and these are already linked, but essentially all you have to do is just mark it, click the link, and add in the URL where this should lead people to. Same as your testimonials or event links or latest videos, whatever you want to put there. Just link that all in here. If you haven't already, you can change the color here. So you can choose a color that is available in here, which are essentially the web colors. Also, sorry, I forgot these. So you can make these links as well. So the email, for example, if we wanna, you might wanna add a link to that one, same as your website. So it's already automatically recognized that this is a link. I will just change this actually to HTTPS. And now it's made them blue. So I can just change this back to black because I don't like this blue. So, but this way people can actually straight away click on it and they're gonna be opening the website or sending an email. And then you just have to click save changes. And then if you create a new email, you can just select whichever signature you wanna use. And it's coming up here. And then don't forget to set your signature default. So you can select here for new emails, use actually this new signature that you created, and it's automatically going to, if you press save changes, and you create a new email, it's automatically gonna drop your signature in there. So there you go. So one more thing, I used to always really like these signatures, which is like a side-by-side sort of format, which is usually created by some sort of a table in the background, because you need to tell basically that you want the image next to the text. However, what tends to happen is that depending on the email program that the other person uses, so you don't know what they're going to be looking the email, what they're going to be reading the email with, and also on mobile, this format can really easily be destroyed by mobile view or other email programs. So I have kind of moved over to this format, which is just sort of going down, because first of all, it gives you a bit more room. You can add more things in, and it's going to work on mobile and pretty much any email program. So you're a lot safer with this format. However, one more thing to add is that Gmail has a limit as to how many characters you can actually use, so you can't make it like crazy long. I think this is pretty much the limit of what you can add here, maybe one more line, but usually that is enough space to put in all your information.
So there you have it. Let me know if this was helpful and if you're going to use this email signature for your business. If you would like more tips and tools for setting up your business online, then check out this playlist here. Now have an amazing day and I can't wait to see you in the next video.